Hi, I'm David Hamilton. You know, one of the subjects that I cover in my new book, Why Woo-Woo It Works, is meditation. And the reason why I cover it is because still in many circles, meditation is considered a woo-woo idea. And I would say that is in large part because people don't fully understand it, you know, understand the point of it, or even what happens, you know, in the brain and body, you know, don't realise that there are actual, real neurological and physiological effects. I mean, for example, if you practice different styles of meditation, research now shows that you can bring about actual different effects in the brain. So for example, if I was to practice mindfulness, so like the basic form of mindfulness, where I might just breathe and then notice that I'm breathing. So I'm mindful of the fact that I'm breathing. Now what I'm doing here is I'm actually taking that part of the brain to the gym. This part's called the prefrontal cortex. I'm taking it to the gym. You know, if you work out a muscle at the gym, the muscle becomes firmer and it becomes larger. So something very similar happens in the brain. It's called neuroplasticity rather than muscle growth. You know, neuroscientists have their own cool terms for these kind of things. But like a muscle growing, that part of the brain, when you work it out through noticing that you're breathing, this attention area of the brain actually becomes thicker. But what if instead I did a different style of mindfulness, where one of the popular forms is, as well as noticing that you're breathing, is you do a body scan. So you place your attention on different parts of the body. But so as I do that, as well as working out this part, I also work out a sensory region of the brain, which also therefore grows like a muscle. So two different styles of mindfulness can impact different regions of the brain, depending on where my mindful focus is. But let's say instead of mindfulness, I went for kindfulness. I call any meditation style that brings about feelings of kindness, compassion, love, warmth, affection, I call these kindfulness practices. Now, as well as impacting this frontal region of the brain, kindfulness practices impact a wee bit deeper, like the medial prefrontal cortex, but also with a slight bias to the left-hand side. And at the same time, develop the empathy region of the brain, a part called the insula, and also dial down the activity of a region of the brain that plays a central role in stress, worry, fear, anxiety, that sort of thing. So there's a very different pattern of activity in the brain if your attention moves away from your breath or your body onto thinking and feeling kindness. But what if instead you were to go for a mantra based technique, you know, like transcendental meditation, or even, you know, when we say like Om or Om Mani Padme Hum, those types of things. Now, what research shows they do is they actually reduce activity in the mental chatter regions of the brain. So rather than being a woo-woo concept, meditation can impact the brain in different ways, and therefore you can choose the style of meditation depending upon what you want to accomplish. If you want to become better at focusing and concentration and maybe even improve your memory, then you might do a mindfulness-based practice, you know, noticing your breath, that kind of thing, or even noticing your thoughts and letting them go, that kind of thing. But if you wanted to become better able to access positive states like happiness and joy, then you might prefer a kindfulness-based practice, which has been shown to help develop those regions of the brain that help us to extract more happiness and joy from the everyday moments of life. Or if you just want to reduce the mental activity, then you might find that a mantra-based technique would be better for you. I mean, you can mix and match. So rather than being woo-woo stuff that's just all in our imagination, there's a really strong scientific basis to meditation. And the key is that different styles can be used to accomplish different things, depending upon what you actually want at the time.